Hello and welcome back. We are on episode 151 of our Oxygen Not Included All Achievement Run. In this episode, we are going to work on a few different things. We're going to work on some radiation, and we're going to try and get some more diamond queued up so we can have maybe change our other rockets so we can mine from a couple at the same time. So we probably will change some of this in the near future. We're going to probably change this right here, including what we have set right here. We want to change this probably to like an ore gate and some other things, so we're going to do some of that. We're going to go for some more artifacts, I think. So let's see, we have a whole bunch in here, but what I wanted to do is click on here and kind of view the different locations. So we've got a whole lot of places that we can check. Let's just look at our star map in general and see. So we have an artifact here, and that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we could send this rocket back and forth from here and back, right? That's probably a good location. A glimmering that's got carbon dioxide, coal, molten tungsten. Okay, now I don't know how we're gonna get molten tungsten back since we don't have the liquid storage, so hopefully that doesn't do any damage to the rocket. We have another glimmering asteroid with the same stuff, and then we have this oily asteroid field right here, so we'll probably grab those later on since we don't really have enough of the materials to go that far. The rockets can only go about 20 tiles with the current amount of the engine type, the petroleum rocket. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start here, grab that with the other one, and then we're also going to check our food. Food is good. And how about the water? Water's fine. Temperature, oxygen, all that looks good. Let's look at our other one. All right, we have water. There's plenty of water in here. Temperature's good. Oxygen looks good. And food, plenty of food. Okay, great. So let's queue up some things here. We're gonna change this to an ore gate. That way we can change how this works. And I want to redirect both of these here. I'm going to change them both to 500. It's not going to be generating the same amount as this one because it's not as close to the Weezworts, but that's just fine. I'm thinking of the last thing I might do in here is add the shine bugs. If we have some shine bugs lying around, I think, just kind of sitting around here, floating around. If not, I know we have the eggs, so we could just move the eggs in there and they can just continually provide extra radiation. Anyways, so let's just let them start working and we will slowly get our stuff situated. Some of the other issues that we were running into is this stuff is really hot, right? Like super duper hot. I think it might be worth coming out of this location, or moving out of this location, and then having a some sort of cooling for this area if we don't want to continually have these issues. Now that if we don't use these, we need to figure out the best way to get everything out of here. So if we just hit the buttons, does it all fall out? I'm not sure, but we are going to find out the next time. So we've got enough oxalite in this tank. We've got plenty of petroleum. Yeah, we may end up making another rocket just for the sake of having another rocket to do mining and all those kinds of fun things. Once we are capable of sending, yeah, it might be better just to have another one. We'll just add another rocket platform. Make it out of iron, that should be fine. Oh no, steel. We'll need to queue up some steel because of how hot it gets. We don't want it to melt or anything like that. So let's go here. 20, queue up that. Let's take a look at our other asteroid. See how this is going. Looks like most of the plumbing is getting completed. We're almost there, and we can kind of change the way that this is going. We will need to... what are we going to do? We are going to take this polluted water that we have in here. Even though it's icky water, we're just going to keep it in the loop, cooling the base where the ethanol is. So we're going to kind of get rid of this extra plumbing, and that's going from up to here. And this is just going to go up and over and down and around and go back and forth. And then we will hopefully be able to add this section to the loop to cool off all the sulfur. And then we will have an automated system to deliver it over here to deliver it right into the conveyor loader. So that's the plan. That's the goal. Hopefully it works that way. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm hoping, and I think we'll get there at some point soon. We don't need to change that. Let's check. How's this going? Everything looks good. Hydrogen is getting backed up. Maybe it would be good to... I think the hydrogen is getting backed up because we're sending a bunch of it over. Right? If we look down here, there's probably a ton of hydrogen sitting in here. Yes, there is. Okay. So let's get this here. One and two. And we're going to add just another ventilation here. I don't want to lose any of this extra hydrogen to overpressure. Right? So we're going to make this a higher priority, get this done, and then, let's see, did we finish this? Oh, well, we're getting close. Oh. Let's add this to the loop, change that up, this goes up here. We need to change the automation to an OR gate. Voila. There we go. Oh boy. We made an oopsie. Well, that's all right. We'll put some more hydrogen in here. All right, and this needs to go in this direction. All right, so we are going to need more hydrogen in here. Unfortunately, we had this issue where I forgot that when we remove stuff, it is in the vacuum of space, so then everything gets lost. We need more hydrogen in here to transfer the heat. So we are going to do this right here. No, 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 no. We're not gonna do that. Let's actually, can we just ventilate this? Yeah, we'll ventilate the oxygen that's laying here, and then we will cut it off. For some reason there was oxygen in that pipe. Interesting. Okay, move on a little bit faster. Everything is looking great though. We're doing really well. I'm not having any complaints whatsoever. Look at all this hydrogen. It's backing up, and it's backing up here. Definitely a good thing. But I think it might be more a better idea to make sure that it's not getting backed up to the point where we are sending hydrogen instead. and we are making a fertilizer section here, so we do need to work on that in a little while. And we're gonna like close it off. It's gonna have natural gas in there and everything, so that'll be pretty helpful. Building broke, liquid pipe, that's on the other location. Okay, that's dormant. Okay, did we get all this done? Let's turn this at a higher priority, please. While that's working, let's take a look at what's going on over here. Okay, so we are sending water here, and then we are going to cut the pipe there. There we go. So this is going to be used to provide extra water to all of these different oil wells in the case that for some reason we run out on the other asteroid. Okay, thank you. And then next, we're going to cut this here. Actually, we'll just send everything. How's the temperature looking here? Honestly, this is overkill since we have the radiator here. All right, so we're getting some more kilograms of hydrogen back in here so we can keep it nice and cold. It was pretty helpful. Definitely helpful. Okay, so now we are getting both germs. All right, so if we look at germs, radioactive contamination, what does it actually do? Let's just look at the database here. Radioactive contaminants. Items tainted with radioactive contaminants emit low levels of radiation that can cause radiation sickness. They are unaffected by pressure or temperature, but do degrade over time. Okay. Interesting. Do we need to have a shower to get rid of the radioactive contaminants? That is my question. I hope not. All right, so let's get this one ready. We're gonna change this. That one's going here. That's great. We've got Rover in here. We've got some glass. We've got copper ore, iron ore. Okay, let's get some more ore because I feel like we will need more. So let's do copper ore and we'll do 1600 kilograms. Okay. And for some reason, the auto sweeper didn't want to do that. That's alright though. How much hydrogen do we have? Okay, we don't have. I want to get about 1,000 grams in each one. So it's going to take a little bit of time, but not too much. This is all not in any sort of use for some reason. Okay. Oh wait, wrong one. That's what I meant to do. All this is backed up, which is a good thing, right? And then if we cut this, does it make it go? It does not, because it's going in this direction. Okay, all right, see, I'm understanding it again. Got it. Alright, so we know where this one's going. Let's go to crew. Let's view the interior. Do our last check once again. No germs. Plenty of food. Right? Rad pills. Algae. That's good. We have oxygen right here. Everything looks good. Let's take a look at our checklist. Pilot's not boarded yet. All right, pilot should be there. Whoosh. All right, I think we are ready. And that's a launch. Awesome. Much better. All right, so this one, where are we gonna go? We're going to take you here, and then we don't need, well, I mean, which crew member do we want? We want whoever has the most piloting. Let's check, take a look at the skills. Who's got piloting? We have advanced piloting. We've got Hassan, Rowan, Ashkan. Oh, Rowan is already on there, so it's going to be between Hassan and Ashkan. All right, so piloting 12, piloting 19. That made my decision for me. Perfect. Let's go in the interior. We're going to do a final check once again. Good. Good. Double good. And then food. Food's good. All right. Star map. Yep, we're going to take the other rocket and it's going to go right to the Wadi El. Put the crew. Get the crew in there and then we'll be good to go. Whew. Okay. Crew's in there. Are we taking a nap or are we on one of those? Nope, we could just probably launch. Let's take a look at what the warning is. What's the warnings? All crew boarded. Crew. Okay, yep. Away we go. Rocket 2, we go. Perfect. Building broke. Is that pipe? It's probably that pipe. Okay, liquid pipe. All right, so when we come back with, well, that looked weird for a second. When we get the rocket back, I want to see the next option for getting the storage out of here. I want to see if we can just uncheck the box if it just drops like the rest of them, because that would be really easy compared to any of the other ways. You know, we're gonna do this forever. It just makes sense just to have it ready whenever they can make it. Great. All right, let's go to the other asteroid. Let's take a look over here, see how everything is coming together. Okay, the pipe is almost done. There's one more section to complete right there. We do need to so we're gonna go backwards. It's going in this direction now, but what we are going to do is have it go back here. Let me think about this. So we wanted to go up, over, and around. So that means we need it to go this way. That's what we need. Let's get rid of these. Okay. That looks great. And then where in relation to these reservoirs? Oh, this is going to be super simple. When we pull all of this ethanol into these reservoirs up here, then we just connect this pipe right there, and then it goes in the loop. This is going to be great. Yeah, let's get rid of these. It just makes sense. Yeah, I'm not going to change anything until all the piping is done. So we're going to change some of the priorities here. Perfect. Let's get some more steel. Oh, we don't have enough iron for that. Let's do 15 iron first, and then we'll get some more steel. Not sure what I was doing with these. Oh, I remember. We were trying to move all of the transformers along the line up here, so then we don't have any laying around over in this direction. But so far that's okay, I think. This was the best choice. Oh. Oops. All right, that looks good. Check our star map. Oh, look. Well, I never saw rockets crossing each other, but now I have. It's a good thing that they can't collide, right? Oh my goodness. All right. I'm gonna change this as well. I wanna be able to see them. And then what do we have here? I like it on top of the sweepy. Perfect. Dracklet. Just grab an extra Dracklet. Don't really need them, to be honest, but it's okay. Wow, we've got a lot of polluted oxygen in a lot of places. So some of the things that I want to start getting ready for, we have a bunch of radiation work that needs to be done. Not this, but more than that in the near future. And I say that because we need to have the different reactors, not reactors, engines that can be utilized with that. So what we want to have is the opportunity to build here. I'm just gonna do new rocket just to, no, I don't want to do new rocket right there. If we look at this rocket platform, right, and we did new rocket, right, we have a carbon dioxide, we've got a sugar engine, we've got a steam engine, a hydrogen, but that requires liquid hydrogen, I believe, so we can't do that until we have super coolant, which honestly that might be the route to go. We have, I think I saw a Radbolt engine. Yeah, that might be just as good, if not better, than the hydrogen engine. So I think that that's, we may play around with these to see which one is better. I don't have any idea as to which one is better. Actually, let's see if we can take a look in our awesome database here. Okay, let's look at Radbolt engine. Okay, that's the build time. Engine power is 34, which is not as good as petroleum. Okay, so what about steam? Steam is lower, so then the next one would be what am I thinking of here? Steam, the liquid hydrogen. I think that's the one. Yeah, this is the next level. So that tells us right now, instead of going with the Radbolt engine, it's going to be, we need to get the liquid hydrogen, right? So I think creating a nice, big, wonderful dilution for this extra hydrogen is going to be one of our next steps. No, I did this wrong. There we go. So we need hydrogen. Like, we should not be venting hydrogen at all whatsoever. We should be keeping it and sending it into this here. Go up and over, and then this is going to go down, and then we're going to cut this. Yeah, this is just weird. We should get rid of this extra. Yeah. Okay. So I think maybe it would be really good to get ready for the liquid hydrogen. So we have -252.2 degrees Celsius. That's how cold we need to get hydrogen. And if we go to the supercoolant. Okay. It can go forever. Well, not forever, but for a really long time. So we need fullerene, we need gold, we need petroleum. Fullerene is, you refine fullerene to graphite and sand, but we're getting straight graphite. So, you can crush that into, what do you do with graphite? Oh, graphite, sulfur, and aluminum gets you fullerene. Okay, so there's a little bit of a process that we have to make the super coolant, and it requires petroleum and gold and fullerene. Okay, so we will need to probably tame that gold volcano that we have right here, because that will be really helpful in delivering extra gold to the other asteroid once we kind of get that other water asteroid situated. So once we have this, yeah, I know things are damaged, it's fine, not a big deal. Once we have all of this graphite, then we can just keep sending it to the main asteroid and then use it to whatever we want, kind of siphon as much of these resources. Oh, that's straight lime, interesting. Lime and fossil, that's why we're sending Dom, so he can get rid of the fossil for us. But yeah, we are going to need a lot of work done. Look at this, the water's actually going down on its own. That I was not anticipating. Right, so are we it's creating pressure and it's pushed up on one side? I don't know if that's the case, but this water was all the way up here before. Kind of neat, right? Kind of interesting. See, it's going down. This is also going down, and this is going up. So kind of eerie that it's going down here and going up over there. Anyways, that might not be a good thing because we have some tile damage here. We may need to add another layer of tiles when we send the rocket, or not the rocket, the rover in here, because that's partially why we're sending the other duplicate in the other rocket here. How many tiles do we have? We have 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm just double checking my math here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 there and 10 back. Okay. Whew. Just got to make sure. Have to make sure. Alright. I'm glad that the diamond was a fairly simple process as well. Did we fix that? No, we did not. Okay. Let's get all these different... what am I thinking of here? Pipes done. We're almost there, and then I can just kind of loop it around and make it better. Now, that's interesting. There's polluted dirt in here. Atmo. For some reason, the Atmo suits made its way here. Interesting. What's in this reservoir? Polluted water. Okay. So we kind of let it go around and around and around. It's just polluted water with a bajillion germs. Okay, interesting. All right, our stress levels here went down, so that's a good thing, right? I was a little worried about that for a while. We had an unfortunate ethanol accident. That was really rough because it consumed a little bit of our time. Is there a plant growing here? Uproot this one, please. We did get to move that pip over. That was good. Oh, random ice there. Okay. We have a little bit of ethanol up here still. What I want to do, I think, is open this up and let it drop down here and over here and just sweep it up. Yeah, I think that that's what we're gonna do. Idleness. All right, did we add all this? We did. All right, so first things first, let's fix all of this extra hydrogen going right into there. Thank you. All right, let's get rid of you and you. And you. I mean, all of this can go, no. This is gonna stay because we want to be able to send hydrogen from the other. Yeah, we go this way now. There we go, much better. Definitely much, much better. All the sticker bombs all over the place. This is great. Do they go away now? Do they have like a timer? Because I thought we had some like over here before. Does anybody know? Let me know what your thoughts are. If you know about that, please let me know. I would definitely like to know if they just expire over time or they become unsticky, quote unquote. I just want to know if they just go away naturally over time. All right, where are the rockets at? Ooh, they're almost there. Okay, we did get some more of this. Ethanol here, ethanol here. What we need to do is... Can we actually mop that up? We could if we had access. Same thing. I'm gonna put one of these right here. Might as well. Well, let's make this a higher priority. There is a little bit too much in here, but that's all right. Plenty of nosh beans. Plenty. I honestly should just figure this out and send them over to the other asteroid, but... Okay, this is almost done. We do need to kind of go over here and just continue fixing up the Transformers situation, because this just looks bad. It just looks bad. Okay, what is this right here? This is petroleum. Okay. So we don't have a lot of petroleum right now. Is that because we have other stuff going on, or is that because... No, we should be fine. It's going in both directions. My guess is we just haven't gotten to it because of all the other stuff we've been working on. Still nothing going on with the dashes, though. Enable auto harvest is enabled on both of those. How about this one? That one too, please. Good. Then we have idleness once again. Yeah, let's mop up, get some of this stuff, put it where it needs to go. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Yeah, this is great. I'm really happy with how everything turned out here. Nice and cold. Oh. Kind of a whoopsie there. It's all right though. That way we can send the extra water to the other asteroid. What we should do is just turn this to 200, let it turn on, and then we'll turn it back to 850. Oh, you know what we need to do as well? We need to repair atmosuits forever. There's 16 of them right now? Wow, that's a lot. Okay, they're not mad anymore, so that's good. I wonder if the egg just hatched, or probably. Let's take a look at what we have on the printing pod. What do we get? Some water. Sure. And then didn't we get wood? I think we got a bunch of it, actually. Wood. 190 kilograms. Okay, so if we decided to distill ethanol... Okay... Produces polluted dirt, carbon dioxide, and ethanol. 73.4 degrees Celsius. Wow. Okay. That is pretty warm, not gonna lie. I was anticipating it being a little bit warm, but not that much. If we do an ethanol distiller... I'm trying to think of if it would be better to do it here or on the other asteroid. And the reason that I want to do this is because we're trying to keep up with the needs of the nosh sprouts, right? Oh, you know what? I didn't even think of this. I could just deconstruct this one. And then have this go straight to the other one. That's gonna give us plenty of ethanol for a while to keep this going. attribute increase. All right. What does our bio look like now? What do we got? Okay. Agriculture is still the highest, but hopefully we'll get some more points. Okay. Did this become... well, disable. No. It's because it's 72 tiles. Okay. So, we want to change these out. We'll go one... no. We will go... 1, 2, 3, 4. Hopefully that should be plenty of room and they can reach all that without any issues. Rocket is in orbit. Okay, let's go to our star map. We want to deploy the orbital cargo. Man, that sounds fun. Let's deploy the rover. Okay, rover's being deployed. Now we take this rocket. Let's move, change the destination. How many tiles do we have? We have 14. So let's go to this asteroid field. We'll grab any artifact that's here. Let's just, before we continue, recharge on the artifact for that one. This is why we're checking. And then what about the other one? Does this one have an artifact? It does. Perfect. Okay. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and back. Okay. So if we wanted to send the Calypso back and forth between this gas cloud, we could if we really wanted to. All right, let's go to the water asteroid. Let's queue up some things for the rock, for the rover to do. It's apparently bugged at the moment, so I'm not going to mess with any of these payloads. What we will do instead is a couple of things. We want to create ladders going across. No, we'll go down one more. And then we are going to make one. Okay. Yeah, we are going to make all this just to prepare for this water that keeps going up because it keeps draining for some reason. It's very bizarre, in my opinion. Yeah, interesting, right? All right. Yeah, I don't know why this water just keeps going up and up and up. I think it's because of this, but I don't want to be too hasty in my assumptions here. And then we're gonna create this go all the way down. I don't know what that said because it went too fast across my screen, but that's all right. This gives the robot something to do. Right? Should be great. Allow, because we need to go three across, right? Three across all the way down to make sure nothing happens pressure-wise. So as we do that, this is the water's going to, I want to say relocate or just kind of move out of that tile, right? So let's check our Apollo rocket. See how that one's going. All right, almost there. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's only 10. We should be good. All right. Did we get enough steel? We did. We have a lot of steel now. We're going to make another rocket platform over here. Just kind of get ourselves ready for another adventure. All right. So we could probably get rid of all these here. Let's get rid of the high pressure gas vent here, and then... Wow. We're getting plenty of diamonds, so this is good. We're gonna make another rocket so we can keep mining everything. We want to make sure that we can just use that drill cone on multiples. We're not going to change the other one until we don't need to travel between asteroids with either the Trailblazer or the rover modules. I know we can just keep changing them when we need to, but I'd rather just have a third rocket with the same capabilities as the other ones. So, you know, it gives us another option just to collect the artifacts and everything else similarly to that. We do need some gold here. Let's get some of that going. 7.3 tons. Wow, that's a lot. You know, I'd probably just do 40, please. Thank you. All right, let's go back to our other asteroid and keep looking at... Okay, piping. The piping is good right now. It's not going anywhere right now. Because of that, right? But what we need to do is up and over and up. Oh, we can't do it yet. We need one more. Should we go down and over and around? Okay, so we need to go up and over in this direction and down, because we're gonna go like that. This is gonna go up like this. We're going to do that, and then it's gonna go down. Yeah, I know, this looks weird. I apologize. We're just gonna make this look right. And then, what am I doing? There we go. All right, so this is gonna go up and over like that, right? We're gonna be flipping the direction of the ethanol loop here. I think that's what I was trying to do. Actually, let's just get it all into these. Yeah, and then we're just gonna cut the pipe here. So we want to take out everything out of this pipe. Honestly, we could probably just do that for a minute. No, I lied. We will just keep it all going. That way we can just flush it out and then reallocate. Oh my goodness. Alright, so this is gonna need to go. All the way over like this, right? And then we're going to change where this is going. Okay, we need to wait a few minutes for that to kind of figure out what we want it to do. What is going on here? Radiant liquid pipe. What happened there? What happened here? We got ethanol in the pipes again? Oh no. How? In the name of everything that has ever happened, did we get ethanol breaking in and out of this? I don't understand. I really don't. You know, you think you've got this stuff kind of figured out, and then out of nowhere, something like that happens, where things are breaking. Yeah, we definitely need to pick up all this ethanol once again. You know what I think it was? I think it was because it was idle and sitting there, it kind of broke stuff. And that was not okay. All right, let's move this a little bit faster. Yeah, we're gonna keep all that in here. Send it to both of them. And then we will fix the piping when all this is emptied. We may need a third reservoir just because there's so much in these pipes. Yep, let's just get ready for that. Let's check our star map. Okay, we are getting all sorts of things. What are we pulling out of here? An egg-shaped rock. Awesome. Okay, so what are we... What do we have? We have wolframite and coal. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Yeah, we need to keep taking care of this because not good with all of the different ethanol out of nowhere. I'm not worried about this side because we have a filter that sends it down there. I'm more worried about this side. Definitely more worried about this side. All right, so we need to kind of watch this for a moment to make sure we don't get any ethanol because there's ethanol up in the air. Yeah, not good. But you know what we could do? We could change this a little bit and have three on this side and two on this side. And then what we'll do is have that be the primary to provide the oil or the crude oil. We could do that. The ethanol is too hot. It's not going to go into liquid form right there. I just have no idea where it came from. It's so bizarre. Yeah, everything is getting pretty hot again because we need to go back to fixing this loop. Okay, now we go up. And then that needs to be highest priority as well. Okay, so what we are going to do is stop this petroleum for a little bit so it sends all of the crude to the other asteroid for petroleum. Okay, did that get done? Not yet. Okay, highest priority, thank you. Okay, so now we are going to be completely relieved of all of this, right? Oh boy. That long save. All right, let's change the priority of these right here. And then we are going to cut the pipe right there, right? No, not there. Here. And then that's why we want this pipe here. this goes down instead. We're gonna pause it right there. Okay, and then get rid of the bridge. Okay. We don't need this pipe anymore, but we do need to change this bridge here and here because it's gonna go in the other direction. Okay, this is gonna go down and then this is gonna go up and then we're going to cut this pipe here. Okay. Now what are we doing? We are going to go, it's going to go this way. We're cutting off the pipe here. Same thing down here. We want to stop it from going in this direction here. Okay. We aren't even going to use this stuff right here except for like this. Okay. So this is going to remain the same. This line is going to go down and up and down. And then we're going to cut these off. We can put them back on when we are ready for that. Okay. So if we're doing it in the opposite direction, it's going to go over. We need to change this bridge and this bridge. And we just need to change all the bridges. Very convoluted. Yeah, let's just look at the plumbing. Get rid of this one. Get rid of this one. And this one. Yeah, we need to flip all of these bridges. I probably could make this different. No. This bridge. There we go. But again, we want to flip it around so that way the, what am I thinking of here? We're flipping around so that these stay cold. We want this to stay as cold as possible. So it's in not refrigerated state, but we want it in the other state. We want it deep freeze. So, all right. So if it comes out here, it goes down and around, over, down, up, and then we should go up and over instead. And then we'll go here, up. Anyways, so what we need to do here is make this better. We need to go up and over, same thing, up and over, and then down and over like that, right? There we go. That is much better. That's how it needs to look. But we are going to cut the pipe here temporarily. Okay. This is the return. So this needs to go up here. We need to go just straight across instead of here. All this is extra. We don't need it. And then that should fix the loop to go the way we want to, minus the bridges, right? All right. Give them some time to complete that. What do we got in the blueprints? Some lime? That's always good. Let's check on our rocket over here. Cargo capacity. Yeah, we don't have capability of holding on to molten tungsten. Sorry. Not bad. Okay, we got the artifact. We can go home on this. Make it home. Did they take care of everything else? Okay, they haven't made the rocket yet, or the rocket platform yet. That's all right, though. We'll get there. We will get there. Okay. So, let's follow this now. So it's going to go down, over, up, and around, down here, all the way down, up, and over here. So we need a bridge here. We need a bridge here, 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 here. This one needs to be deconstructed still. Okay. So follow this around. That one needs to be deconstructed. These need to be deconstructed. Okay. We're getting there, everyone. We are getting there. We also need to put the bridge the other direction. We need to go here and here. And here and here. Okay. Perfect. It's going to make it nice and easy. I see. Things might have gotten too cold or too warm or something along those lines, but yeah, what we may have to do is force this side to be the main, or we add, honestly, I think I'm just going to do another liquid filter here. Because we have the power. Definitely have the power for it. So I think that is what the best route here is going to be. So we're going to flip this around like so. We're gonna throw a liquid bridge. No liquid bridge. We don't really have an option here. And then that's gonna be in and out. We're going to leave that alone for now. Let's grab the power, go straight across. And then what do we do with the extra? It might be easier to go in the opposite direction. We will have to wait and see. Okay, all these need to be higher priority. We need to get this all done. Yeah, all of it's a little too hot, so we're moving fast, moving really fast. How are we over here? We're getting there, almost filled to the brim. All right, so since that's kind of a hard spot to provide what we need, and that's kind of just gonna change. So we're gonna go like this. We're gonna go over, back in, and then a liquid bridge, and then we can descend this. Honestly, we can send it right here because it's going to be cancel that. It's either going to be two things. It's going to be a... What am I thinking of? It's going to be either ethanol or it's going to be crude oil. So I think this is going to be fine. Everything's going to be fine. We're not going to have any issues. Everything's going to be perfect. Does that got the highest priority? No, it does not. We're going to lose food very quickly here. Okay. We're doing pretty well. I'm going to keep going for a little bit longer here. We need to make sure that we are getting all these bridges completed. Okay, let's look. Oh, we got another one right there that needs to be highest priority. Pretty please. Yeah, this is a constant struggle, I think, with this asteroid. You know, keeping this stuff nice and cold. And honestly, I feel like this is harder than the other asteroid, than the first one. Soilora, I think. Soilora, I think that's how you say that. Maybe, could be wrong. Okay, are we done? I think we are done. Let's go back. Go back home. Okay, did we get... No, we did not get all of them done yet. Okay, this is getting completed, which is good. Alright, we don't need to do this anymore. We do need to do that right here, though. And then we'll pick up this ethanol. Hopefully, before it turns into gas. Or a second or third time. Alright, this bridge needs to be like top tier priority. Same thing with this one. We really need this stuff to get completed. Okay, that one's done. Good. That bridge is done. The other one is done. Okay. Now let's see about this stuff getting to the highest priority as well. Once that's complete, we should be good to go. Unless my calculations are incorrect, which has been known to happen every once in a while. Okay. All that's getting done. That's good. Thanks, Harold. Thank you, May. You guys are doing a wonderful job. And Ellie, of course. All right. Yep, I think this is good, because all this is going to start cooling off everything once again. Oh, yeah, that looks fine. Okay, and then how's this working? It's working great. Actually, good. Oh. That's what we need to do. We need to add another liquid bridge setup. Here and here. and those need to be the highest of priorities. Perfect. You guys don't need to be like that, though. You guys can stay at, like, a 6. Okay. And then these can be... Oh, they are 9 already. Good. Once again, changing these down. There we go. Let's mop those up. Let's also... Okay, where is this stuff going? Oh. Okay, now it's going. Okay. Good. We have another printable. Let's do pip eggs. Good. Okay, last couple of ones. Come on, let's get them done so that way it can go all the way across. Okay, all that's done now. So we should be good. It should work the way we want it to. These ones are not in use right now, but they will be soon, right? Okay, same thing here. Let's make these the highest priority. We definitely want crude oil to be that. And then we want to cut this pipe here. Come on, let's get the last two things done. Thank you. Awesome. Okay. All right. So the ethanol is probably not going to be the best choice. Obviously, using polluted water is probably better, but again, we're doing what we can with what we've got. So, oh, stuff is getting by the oxygen because the hydrogen is getting filled to the brim. Okay, so let's do this again. No, 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 don't do that. Let's do this for a little while at least. Fix that issue temporarily. And then now this ethanol should be going around and around and around. Perfect. Okay. So we are going to slow it down right there. I think that this is a good stopping point since we've transition to only one section of the steam turbines to keep these cold, or to keep this one line cold for the different areas that we have designated, mainly for the oil wells. So that's kind of what the whole purpose of that is. We're going to add these with polluted water instead and kind of adjust that in the next episode. We have a lot of other stuff that we are working on, including more of these artifacts. We have 2 artifacts on the way from both of our different rockets that we have here, along with extra materials, which is always good, always necessary. We have, you know, balm lilies being made that we're trying to mutate. We have a bunch of the other 2 over here. We've got the Nosh sprouts and the Dasha seeds that we're trying to get mutated over here. So those are just the main things that we've been working on, and hopefully in the next episode or two we can continue with that trend of knocking out each individual portion of those achievements. But anyways, that's it for this one, folks. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. We'll see you in the next one.